Hello children, in the last class we started Vadas of Mysore, no? In that we learned about the Tipu Sultan, Hyder Ali and four arrows of Mysore. Yes, the continued part only I am taking today. Yes, see children, in the early Vadas, that first Vadas the ruler of Mysore kingdom is Yaduraya. Then after in the among the early Vadas, Chikka Devaraya is the famous one. He got the title Navakoti Narayana, he built the Atara Kacheri and he introduced the fifth administration. All this one I explained. After that, it is taken by the Hyderabad. Then it is ruled by the Sultan Tipu Sultan. But in between Hyderabad British and the Tipu Sultan British, there were four wars that we also learned. After death of Tipu Sultan, the Mysore province went under the control of British. But British divided that one into four parts because before attacking the Tipu Sultan, they made agreement with the Nizam and Marathas. So they divided the Mysore province in the four parts. One part they given to the Marathas, another one to the Nizam, and third one they taken. The last fourth small part they given to the Vadas. So from the earlier it belongs to the Vadas only. But in between it is taken by the Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan. So this kingdom again is given to the Mysore Vadas. That time they given to the Krishna Devaraya Vadas third. For him they given the administration to rule. But what happened that time, the Krishna Devaraya Vadas was just 5 years old boy. He is unable to manage the kingdom. Because of that purpose, British made Purnaya as Prime Minister, Diwan of the Mysore province. But once there was a revolt in the village Bindur, it is in Shivamogga district. But Krishna Devaraya was unable to suppress that revolt. Then British thought that he is unable to manage the kingdom. Again, they taken back Mysore from the Vadas. Then they introduced the commissioner rules. They cancelled the king's rule only. They given the administration to the commissioners. That one they are learning today. See, the administration of commissioners started in the Mysore province. Two commissioners ruled that one. That is Mark Kabbar. He ruled from his administration was up to 1834 to 1861 CE century. Then another one commissioner, his name is Louis Grantham Borel. He ruled from 1892 to 1870 century. See children, these were not kings, British officers there, commissioners there. So they are not having any intention to extend the kingdom, grabbing the money and all they are not having. So they improved a lot that Mysore province. So long back only the incremental work started in the south part because of these commissioners. So, because of that only they are well developed and lot of improvement you can see in that province. See, Bengaluru, Kabbar Park is there, children. Heard the word? So, it is in the name of this Commissioner Odi. Boring Hospital and all is there. That is also in the name of Commissioner Odi because that much good work they did. Just main things what improvement which is not in your syllabus, this time they removed this one, children. So just what improvements they made in the Mysore province, I will note that one. See, Mark Kabbar, what he meant, telegrams line he laid down. Telephone he started. Railway line from Bengaluru to Jolarpet, that one he started. Then the kingdom was divided in, first he made it, divided the kingdom into parts for the smooth administration. He divided as a taluk, districts like this. To manage that one, he made the laws. To maintain that law and order, he established the judiciary. Court he established, police station he established. Lot of improvement now it is. So like this way, he started the developmental work. Then, Kabbar Park is in his name only, I said that one. All this one he made. Then, Louis Bentham Borel, this commissioner also made many changes to them. First, he organized the judicial administration structure. What are the drawbacks are there in the early commissioners? That one he improved. and land revenue collection system also he reorganized. Judiciary and police department he properly established. Then introduced the educational reforms also. Then public instruction department established. What people want? What are their demands? What is their problem? To ask that one, he made the public instruction department. And he laid out the foundation for the development in the Mysore province. So you can say, because of these two commissioners only, lot of development was there in the Mysore province. But he resigned in the year 1861, and this commissioner resigned in the year 1870. After this one, again British thought that it is better to go back again to the Wadiyar Samindra Road. Once they given to Krishna Devaraja Wadiyar III. Now again they are thinking to give the Mysore administration to the Wadiyar Swami. So they given the Mysore rule to the Chamaraja Wadiyar X. For him they given. So again they given. Once they given to Krishna Devaraja Wadiyar III. Second time they are giving the Mysore rule to the Wadiyars. Second time not yet. So this is called as the Punaragamana. Punardana. It is called as the Punardana. Punar means again. Dana. Because once they given to Krishna Devaraja Wadiyar, this is second time they are giving. So it is called as the Punardana. And Chamaraja Wadiyar 10, he ruled from 1881 century to 1894. But since then, when the British were ruled to this world, that time he was 11 years old, small boy. But mother was very clever. On behalf of her son was sitting in the throne. But on behalf of son, every administration is done by his mother. Her name is Nanjamani. Nanjamani. Yes. Mother name. She ruled that one after grown up when he was 18 years. That time he taken the rule. Actually, in this year only started the rule. And he well he managed. But once he went to Calcutta, there only because of ill health, he died. After him, Nalvadi Chamaraja Wadiyar came to the administration. That one he learned. So, take this one. Punardana said that is he giving the power to the Mysore Wadiyars. After Chamaraja Wadiyar 10, Nalvadi Krishnaraja Wadiyar came to the power. In the 1885 only got the kingship. But he actually his rule started during 1902 because he was 11 years old. On behalf of his son, mother, Nanjamani, who used to do the administration work, as I said. And to establish the People's Representative Committee to discuss the problems of the people. And he made lot of achievements in the, I wrote on the board, that one I'll explain one by one. See children, first thing, he built the Mysore Palace. It is completed, long back only the construction started, but it is completed in the year 1910. What present is there now? That Mysore Palace. Before that, one more was there, children. It is in the wood. But once what happened, there was a marriage ceremony in the Mysore Palace. Accidentally, that palace got fire and it burned. Then Mysore Wadiyar started planning the one more palace. That is, what present is there now? That palace. Mysore Palace only it is called. So, before completing that one, Wadiyar family used to live in the Jagannath Palace. In front of that palace is there. There they used to stay. Okay. So, present Mysore Palace is completed during the Nalvadi Krishnaraja Wadiyar's time only. Then, completed the ARS Dam. Krishnaraja Sagar Dam. ARS. Very famous one. Mystical fountain and all is there. Vrindavan Garden is there in front of that one. You may be knowing all this one. Yes? Yeah. That one completed during the Nalvadi. Jalbadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya time only. Long back only we started, but completed in this road. Lot of contribution is there. Sorry, Vadaiya in the completion of Krishna Raja Vadaiya. Queen Jalbadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya. Queen only given all our ornaments because there was a financial crisis in the Vadaiya family. Then they are thinking that it is not possible because lots of money needed to complete that dam. So they are planning to give up that plan for construction of the dam. That time, Vadaiya's queen given the all her armament. Inspired by that queen, whole kingdom, many people, common people also contributed their money, gold, silver for the construction of the dam. Because of all their contribution only, now we are having the ARS dam. And it is providing the irrigation facility, drinking facility to the South India. Okay? Yes. Then, he given the reservation for the backwater maybe. See, children, in the olden time, lower caste people were very backward. They are not having any facility. They were suppressed in the society. To improve them, to develop them, he started reservation. Legislative assembly started, people's representative committee started, and all that work he started giving reservation for the backward community people to develop them. Followed, before our government only, Vadaiya started all this institution. Then, voting power given to the woman for the first time in Karnataka. See, one more great thing. Women are not having the voting power, children. Only men has to put the vote in the election and all. But the Chavaraja Vadaiya, Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya given the voting power to the woman. That is first time in Karnataka. Yes. Then, this Vadaiya given 371 acres of land and 5 lakh rupees to the J.N. Tata. That is a technical institution, Tata institution. For that one, he given this much land and the money for the development of that one. Because industries are there, means development is there. That one, because of that one, he given. Then, legislative assembly has started to ask the problems, to solve the problems of the people. That is in the year 1907. And he was guide and motivator for all the development fields. He used to guide either in the education, industry, or banking, whatever field, or in all the development field, he used to encourage the people. Guide as well as the motivator. Guide as well as the motivator in all the fields. Then, for the administration of the work, he appointed the talented divans, educated, well educated, who are following the administration. That one he appointed. Two divans were there during the Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya time. First one is Sir M. Vishwesaraya, engineer is. In the next the class, we are going to learn in detail about this divans of the Sir M. Vishwesaraya, one. And the second one is Sir Mirza Ismail. These two are the divans who helped Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya in the administration. See, children, authorities, according to their will and wish, they used to make the rules and regulations. And they are interested in ragging the war, extending the kingdom. Because of their fame and all, they used to build many monuments, buildings and all. Lot of money they are spending in that. But these warriors, they spent their money for the development of their kingdom. Because of that only, everything improved. Vishwesaraya only more contributed for the ARS dam. Then Sir Mirza Ismail, he made the Vrindavan Garden and Irwan Canal and all. He planned to construct in the Mysore products. Like when we are learning about the divans, that time we learn in the detail. These are all the achievements of the Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya. For our children, once Gandhiji visited the Nalvadi Krishna Raja Vadaiya's kingdom, he saw all the prosperity. People were happy. Everywhere development work was there. Everything was improved. So he described his kingdom as a Rama Raja. Rama Raja means what, children? happy and everywhere development was there and peace was there. That is called Ramaraja. It is like that only. Like that he compared the Nalbadi Vishnuraja Wada kingdom to the Ramaraja. So he described it as a Ramaraja. Got it? Then he given the title to the Nalbadi Vishnuraja Wada as a Rajashri. He given the title to the Gandhiji, given the title to the Nalbadi Vishnuraja Wada as a Rajashri. Followed children. So this is all about the Nalbadi Vishnuraja Wada. Take this point today. Yes, Nalbadi Vishnuraja Wada will be the last one, sir. After that, our government will be for. Okay, take these points. Yes, for today's session, you know, these two homeworks, that is, what is Punarbhava? You have to write that word. Name the two important commissioners of Mysore. Commissioners. How did Gandhiji describe the Mysore state? Then name two divans of Mysore state. Two divans and two commissioners are there. Don't be confusion. Write this answer. It is in the next class I will make little bit about the divans of the Mysore. That is Saurabh Vishveshwaraya.